and welcome back to yet another episode of the Realty Plus show on Republic Television. I am Amit Bhagwan Wadhwani, and the big question today, real estate, who is buying and who is not? Are millennials looking at buying their apartment or they prefer renting in? There was a time where, you know, I used to be in the 25, 26 and I always wanted to buy an apartment. But I think with times, the trends keep changing. What was prevalent in 2008 could not be the case in 2018. We'll find out today.
Amit Wadhwani, our anchor and the host, brings his enigma and in-depth knowledge of real estate, Anurag Batra. Dr. Batra is the man with many hats and is one half of the show that busts the many myths associated with real estate. Neh Srivastav has held a whopping number of important portfolios under the Government of India. In over 20 years, he has contributed greatly in policy making in the field of public demand, policy formulation and implementation. Ankur Gupta, with 15 years of experience in the industry, has the Ashiana Senior Living Projects to show for his great contributions. Ankur Gupta currently heads marketing and sales of the company while also maintaining the facility management segment. Rakesh Yadav, in 1996, Rakesh Yadav laid the foundations for Antriksh Group with a core mission of setting up new benchmarks of quality and lifestyle in a field of real estate. Holding an MBA as well as a civil engineering degree, has contributed many high-end projects across India. Ashish Bhutani is a young and dynamic corporate leader spearheading the Bhutani Group's success story. He's not only a corporate captain focused on project conceptualization and delivery, but also a tough leader bringing a global outlook towards commercial real estate development in India. Karan Bhatia has a vision of creating noteworthy additions to urban landscape through creative collaborations with passionate people in the real estate industry, aided with the entry of a younger generation into the growing field of real estate, with the aim to bring international design and concepts to Ahmedabad. Ashish Agarwal has always introduced products which have given the company an edge in the market. He has the innate ability to innovate products which gives his team consistent results.
So we have the big question today is, what are millennials doing today? I think it's one of the in word today. What do you think the youngsters today, do they really wish to buy an apartment, or they want to just chill out or have a nice time?
I think these are not exclusive things. They, of course, like to enjoy life, but part of that enjoyment is owning a house.
Right.
So it's not either or. They are very responsible. They are much more mature. And today, the entry salaries allow them to buy a house.
70-75% as per a recent research, the sales come in from youngsters, millennials. Do you feel that they are really interested in taking a home loan, really working for 20 years, paying those EMIs, working about their CIBIL records and all of that?
Yes, they are.
Yeah.
Because, every Indian learns from his parents or grandparents, buy your own house. So it's a mindset. It provides you the most mental security.
I'm sure to get married, it was one of the prerequisites for most Indian men to buy a house. Let me quickly get on to Ashish. So you've studied abroad and you've stayed, you know, in different parts of the globe. Do you think there is a difference in the ideology of somebody who is staying in the UK, US, a millennial there, and a youngster here in India as far as home buying is concerned?
Absolutely there is. I mean, if you take UK, for example, youngsters there, they get their salaries every Friday. By Saturday or Sunday, they have spent most of it. Maybe the provisions to spend or where they can actually go out clubbing or various things, they're more in England. If you compare that to India, there's still a limitation. And the mindset predominantly in India is to save money.
People in Ahmedabad, because you have business set up in Ahmedabad, I heard you talking about that the luxury market is doing very well. The affordable housing is not doing so well. So why do you feel,
So generally what I feel with Ahmedabad is that it's more of a business oriented crowd. But when we talk about India on a whole,
Are youngsters really the decision makers there?
over there in terms of what the final product is, yes.
Are they buying for themselves or are they taking decisions for their fathers?
They are doing both. Yeah. That's what I feel. And I think that's how the developers are changing as well. Because right. now when we make projects, we have to make that keeping the millennials in mind. Right. Keeping the youngsters in mind. So that's the primary focus.
Let me quickly get sir onto this. Sir, so what do you think about this article? You think these youngsters are taking decisions more than there was a time youngsters used to only look at which car to buy, which watch to buy, what to give to the father and mother on a birthday. But as far as real estate developers are concerned, their targeted marketing is now towards youngsters, millennials.
You go to the 18 to 85.
Jee.
The person who will purchase the house, the age is 45 to 50.
Right.
Now, when the person will start their service, their life, he will purchase
Correct.
Their own house. The concept is now there's nuclear families.
Correct.
Due to that reasons, as on date we can see that a small, beautiful house.
Jee.
Not more space.
Right. So how small is another big question there. But you know, a lot of my developer friends are telling me we are creating small houses because the youngsters want it that way. They like the Japanese concept. They want privacy. So all this is really, let me get Uncle to talk about this. Is it done to save your FSI cost? Is it done to sell stuff because largest flats don't get sold? So we are talking about smaller units, saying that agar youngsters ko to yehi chahiye, aap yehi banaya karo, yehi bik jayega.
I think what happened was, I think the land cost, the construction cost, which kind of went up. So overall, the cost of buying a big house when the recession came was not available.
Right.
So a lot of developers went to smaller houses. But to give you an idea, in the last 6 months, our average sizes of sales have gone up by 8%. So what we were selling at 1,280 square feet on average, now we're selling at 1,380 square feet average. So overall, there's a movement to bigger sizes.
Right. And what's the kind of trend that you are seeing?
Now, I suppose, as rightly pointed out by others, but there is a shift from in the thought process of the families.
Right.
Kids do get involved in the decision making.
That's a very small part of the millennial buying population that buy real estate, that invest. The fundamental difference when millennials make a choice is they're making a choice for self-use,
correct,
for occupation. So what they would have paid in rent is what they are paying as EMI.
Right.
So in that sense, it kind of equalizes. Second thing is, because we're talking of millennials, which my friend developers have said are between 70 to 80% of the buyers.
Right.
They seek information online. So they are very informed.
Right.
They know about the developer. They know about the projects.
Correct.
They've ran their calculations.
Right.
Third, you must understand from a life cycle of a real estate buyer.
Hmm.
Once you bought a house and your family expands, these are the buyers that will buy their second house, which is bigger. Their salaries would have gone up. So as a buyer class, this is the most important class because they're starting low at an entry cost.
Right.
But they will continue to upgrade during. So from a marketing standpoint, from a CRM standpoint, from a future sales standpoint, this asset buying millennials are the most important real estate buyers.
Right, Sash, what do you think about this? Because what is coming of age today is digitalization, mobile phone, the life is in a mobile phone, access to information, what you see is what you demand. The minute you see the brochure, you see the amenity, you come on ground zero, you ask the sales guy whether this is what is promised, this is what I can see. Maybe somebody who, like my mom or dad, couldn't really have thought of, you know, checking online the stuff before going on ground zero purchasing. Do you feel that this is encouraging for the industry or this is detrimental?
No, in a way it's encouraging because information is always encouraging, and with the age which the real estate is in right now, more information is better for the consumer, and more transparency is also better. So I would say that it's good in that way.
Right.
But coming on to the point of millennials buying or not buying, I would say that there is definitely a shift.
Right.
There is a shift. People are preferring to take apartments on rent.
Right.
That's not only because they are...
Apartment on rent or are they purchasing?
They are preferring on rent in this scenario.
Right.
Because they want to delay their decision.
Somebody told me that because there was demonetization in the country, the cash went out of the system. And now transactions are 100% white. So the poor 25-year-old guy can pay a 10% out of his pocket as OCR margin money and 90% can be funded. Let me quickly get Sanjay Raj Gupta. I know of you and your very bright kid, Aryan, who is now in the United States, who takes decisions almost on all aspects. In fact, you consult your 18-year-old kid who's in the US now. Do you think he'll come back to India and buy an apartment and continue to stay in the US?
Of course. So he's studying in the US. His life is in the US. But do you think he will still want to buy an apartment in the homeland in India?
See, no Indian can forget his mother country. So he has to come back. That is for sure. But if there is a call,
I think there's a sense of security. There is a sense of, you know, belongingness, and roti, kapda, makan are three things that people would want to buy back here in India.
Let me ask Karan, what is one thing that you are doing to encourage young buyers buy in your projects?
So generally, when I look at young buyers right now, they don't want the basics. They don't want basic things. They want an experience.
Right.
So right from when they walk into your office to when you know you give them the house key,
right,
everything should be an experience. So that is one thing that is the primary focus.
And Karan, how do you create that experience?
So
experience is such a abuse term in every business. People want it. They want
luxury,
it in the food business.
Correct. Affordable.
They want it in the
experience primarily when I talk about young buyers is towards the touch and feel, towards where they see your communications, which is now moved to online a lot.
Yeah.
And when we're talking about projects, I think they are somewhere ready to compromise on the size of the apartment.
Right.
Or the location,
if they are getting the amenities, if they are getting the convenience of their workplace being nearby. You know, so these are the trade-offs that we are seeing right now.
Is there anything that you're doing in your projects so that it appeals to people who
are here?
Interesting two things which we make sure. But what we realize is when they have kids is the time when they start looking at the house, because now they want to settle in a particular job in a particular location. That drives it. And secondly, what we have done is we started trial apartments in our projects where these consumers can come and stay and experience lifestyle, meet friends, create a buzz. So just understand the product, is it for you or not? And so I think that's the kind of experience which we're talking about.
Sir, आपको क्या लगता है कि ये जो trend जो चल रहा है कि जो अभी 25-26 साल के लड़के लड़कियां हैं जो एक time पे पढ़ाई किया करते थे 30-32 साल तक, 25 साल में वो घर ले गए हैं, फिर 30 साल में दूसरा घर ले गए हैं और पेंटहाउस ले गए हैं, जो फ्राइडे तक कमाते हैं वो सैटरडे खर्च कर देते हैं, तो आपको ऐसा लगता है ये ट्रेंड सस्टेनेबल है?
नहीं,
ये चल सकता है आगे?
देखिए, जब फोन के अंदर ये सिस्टम चल सकता है तो हमारे यहाँ क्यों नहीं चलेगा? बड़ा सिंपल सा रिप्लाई है. जो चीज़ें अधिक आज वर्ल्ड वाइड ग्लोबलाइजेशन हो चुका है
जी.
तो जो चीज़ें वर्ल्ड के अंदर हैं वो एक दिन इंडिया में आएंगी
जी.
तो जो सिस्टम आज पूरे वर्ल्ड में है वो इंडिया में रहेगा. तो जो बच्चों का आपने बताया, एक वन बेडरूम से 5 बेडरूम और पेंट हाउस तक जाना, ट्रेंड चलता रहेगा.
बट बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग कह रहे हैं कि मुझे लोन लेना नहीं है, मुझे घर लेना नहीं है, मैं रेंट पे ही खुश हूँ. बिकॉज हाउ डू यू आंसर दिस, टेल मी, एन अपार्टमेंट इन मुंबई वुड कॉस्ट यू 3 crore rupees, अ स्मॉल अपार्टमेंट इन बांद्रा, द रेंटल ऑफ दैट अपार्टमेंट इज 80,000 rupees.
So see clearly.
Ultimately, it's the experience of consuming, staying in the apartment. You get the same sea view, you get the same amenities, you get everything. Why own it? Your loan is also 20 years. Your rental is 36 or 33 months.
Amit, you're thinking very logically.
Yeah.
Home buying is not very logical. No,
yeah. That opens up a very interesting set of debate. But allow us to come back in a moment from now. We are having a very, very important and a very interesting discussion in a moment from now. Let us quickly understand from a policy standpoint. Millennials keep saying, yeah, Sarkar, why do I vote? What is the government doing for me? But do you want to tell them what is, from a policy standpoint, what attracts millennials to pay higher tax, to make your Mohan? What is the concept behind a home loan and interest rates, and why it is comparatively lower than a business loan? What are the, from a policy standpoint, what are the things the government is doing?
Obviously, because habitation is one of the important requirement of everyone.
Right.
And that is why government want to support the cause.
Right.
Roti, kapda aur makan.
Ji.
Zarurat aaj se, jab Indira Gandhi thi, tab bhi thi aur aaj bhi.
Ji. Ji.
So that stands still there.
Right.
So that is the reason government gives the loans at a lesser rates,
right,
home loans at a lesser rates than personal loans or any other loans.
There is so much of land in Noida. There are so many projects which are yet to be completed. Invest time, money in completing those projects, deliver those apartments, come out of the mess. You know, what do you
That's
think
true.
About this?
Okay, so I was just going to agree to the point that he put up brilliantly, that land is one thing you cannot produce in a factory. We are only given that much.
Right.
So the rate for land and the demand for it is only going to go up on
right.
Unfortunately, for real estate, land is one of the basic things we need.
Even
to
do you agree with this?
I partly agree that land is limited. But let me tell you what is going to happen. I'm not an astrologer, I'm not a futurist. But let me tell you that...
But you are from the media.
But we are supposed to know the future. And I hope we do predict the future.
Yeah.
But coming back is, let's take, I'll give you an example of Bombay, then I'll give you an example of Delhi. In Bombay, you have police lines, okay? Now, there may be collaboration opportunity between a private developer and
public.
Yeah. So that will create land banks. And these land plots are in premium locations. So as long as the housing for the police personnel is met for, you'll have enough stock. And I have knowledge of these availability. So let's take a Delhi, NCR, defense land. As the government tries to create more revenues for itself to deal with what's happening in the environment, you will see one of the things that the government will turn to is these defense lands. There will be collaborative opportunities there. So land will come. And the cities have expanded. Yeah. So there is land on the fringe. Right. So I understand that but I don't think the prices will go up in the way developers want them to go up.
So my take on the land side is this, that, you know, and I love Toll Brothers said this, that every time I go to look for land, I find it. Yeah. So why is it infinite? Is it finite or every time I'm looking for
it? It is the price. The developers want to purchase the land at a value called zero and make multiples of money. That's what the consumers...
We're all looking as a developer, as a consumer, everybody wants to reduce pricing, everything. Yeah. We all want lesser, more for less. Right. That's the market which we all are in. But what we have to take a call is what's the right price and where we are selling and what is the... Yes, where is the market...
Every year, 5 to 7% market escalation will come in 9 years. As on date, you can see... Your data, everything will increase, price of the petrol, price of the raw
metal. You're talking about inflation, basically. But real estate as an asset class is a basic...
When the cost of the product is high, so I will purchase a house today, 60 lakh. After 9, what is the cost of that house? It should become around about 120.
Or it's a very interesting thing. So, आपको ऐसे लग रहा है कि इस साल जो घर की कीमत है, अगले साल उससे ज़्यादा होगी?
100% When your construction cost will be increased, so house cost, how you can reduce that? Only that way.
Do you agree with this? Then what happened when the prices went down and everybody said that I don't want to buy an apartment, I don't want to buy offices, cancel my booking, give me my money back? When the prices went up, everybody wanted to book profits. And when the prices went down, people wanted to take their money back.
Amit, the differentiating factor is that right now the buyers are looking to buy for self-use. When buyers bought then, they were looking for escalation.
When I speak to any youngster, he says, Amit, aapke paas koi, can you suggest a small apartment, 50, 60 lakh rupees, where I can invest? They still use the same language. I stay in a 3 BHK with my mom and dad and we have another 2-3 properties, but I want to have my own apartment. Can you tell me where I can invest? Investment kahan hai? With GST, stamp duty, you're minus 18% on day one. How is real estate a good investment for somebody who's taking a loan with a step-up, step-down plan with so many home loans? Are millennials in the right direction?
It's about a peace of mind. Traditionally, the way Indians have grown up is that, you know, the house is the biggest investment. And if you look at, it is possibly the biggest investment that an individual makes in his or her lifetime, whether once or multiple times. So in that sense, it is an investment, even if it's for self-use. Right. The terminology is, it's something that is an investment.
As a young entrepreneur, let me have this quick rapid fire, this thing. You're a young guy, you're also catering to the young population in Gujarat and various parts of the country. We've discussed this earlier. Do you want prices to go up or down?
To be honest,
do you want prices to go up or down?
If I'm talking about per square foot, I want them to go up.
Why?
But naturally, this is my business, right? So I would want the price to go up because my costs are also going to go up. But
what about absorption? As the prices keep going up, already we are struggling to sell apartments in major...
So the size goes down. So that is what we're seeing over
the past... That's a very honest confession. As the prices go up, the size goes down. And that is a major concern of most people in the country, whether 30 square meter, 60 square meter is habitable.
The quality and amenities are also going up, Amit. So it's not that...
So
today, the quality of what you put into a home is usually better than what it used to be 5 years.
You know, we were on a panel discussing on affordable housing schemes, safety of labor is compromised because the developer feels 2500 rupees ka construction hai, let me bring it down to 1800 rupees. So they are compromising on certain important factors in the name of affordable housing as the sizes go up. Do you agree?
No, that should not be happening. See, that is, you know, what I say is make a good product, people are always there to pay for it. You know, so that value should be seen in the product and you don't compromise.
Aisha, what's your take on this? Do you want prices to go up or down?
I don't.
If prices go down, you'll do more business, more volume business.
I don't want prices to go up, but they will go up.
One reason, why do you think so?
Inflation, the steel price.
I think today is one day I am not getting support either from the right or the left on any of my opinion on the subject. But I certainly want prices to correct further.
It's an industry now. It's already an industry. It's being treated like an industry. Everywhere you go, it's being treated like an industry. Earlier, it was like an investment. Mm. So right now, what is happening is if you are buying a house, that factor that how much will it become has to come out of the consumer mind. He has to not think like that. He has to, like, he's buying a car.
Correct.
He'll not think that how much will it appreciate when I'm going to sell it.
Right.
So house is not something like you can just...
You should not trade on real
estate. You should not trade on it.
Yeah.
You should be, take it, you are an actual user. Just go, buy a house. You like it, buy it. If it's in your budget, you can pay for it, go and buy it.
Let me say there is a new normal. I think today the players in real estate are serious players who can sustain, who can complete. It is only attracting those kind of developers who have the right balance sheet and the right intent. So from here on, the industry is getting in some way restructured. In that new normal, the buyers will get what they want in terms of product, in terms of pricing.
But are the youngsters believing in what you're saying? Are the youngsters believing? Are the
decision makers
believing?
The decision makers are seeing what's happening in the environment, they're choosing from what's available to them.
Right.
So in that, the prices may come down as a part of competition, but overall the input cost of a real estate is growing. The land cost is growing, the steel cost is growing, the labor cost is growing, the taxes have gone up. So to expect the real estate industry to suddenly lower their pricing 40% is an unfair expectation.
So, sir, you are from Gurgaon, right? आज गुड़गांव फैशनेबल स्टेटमेंट है ये कहेंगे कि कुछ भी हो जाए मुझे तो रहना गुड़गांव में ही है
देखिए
चाहे छोटा हो बड़ा हो मुझे गुड़गांव में ही रहना है या मुझे साउथ दिल्ली में रहना है
द गुड़गांव मार्केट इज नॉट ए रियल स्टेट मार्केट इट इज ए शेयर मार्केट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इन गुड़गांव मैक्सिमम आर इन्वेस्टर्स
एक जमाना था वैसे
बिकॉज़ वी आर इन नोएडा गुड़गांव
आई
थिंक विद द सेकंड एयरपोर्ट कमिंग इन यूपी क्लोजर टू नोएडा आई थिंक द एक्सप्रेसवे इज ऑलरेडी एक्सेप्टेबल एज अ लोकेशन फॉर पीपल टू लिव इन आई थिंक नोएडा विल गेट मोर एंड मोर ल्यूक्रेटिव एज अ
I understand the sentiments of everybody who is from Delhi and NCR. We do a segment only on what Noida and Gurgaon has done to India. Sir, what do you think prices should go up? What do you want, prices to go up or down?
As a consumer, I would like prices to come down.
In the capacity of the chair that you occupy?
Then obviously it will go up. As rightly said, the prices are increasing, the commodity prices are increasing, taxes are increasing.
My TRPs of the show will keep falling down. Sir, what do you think about prices going up or down? Do you want prices to go up or down? If prices do go up, because 80% of the panel has agreed that prices will go up, do you think youngsters will continue to buy?
So every time there will be a market which will go up and down, and there will be corrections which will keep happening.
Right.
And you know, it's very difficult to say if the market, what time will the market will go up.
So point taken. Sanjay sir, what is your final take on this?
I personally feel sales should go up, prices wherever they may be.
Superb. I think you know. So that is a typical developer from India speaking about sales, and sales. I often ask developers, sir, what do you want from a marketing standpoint? Creativity, should we do X, Y, Z? He keeps telling me, aapko jo karna hai, aap karo. At the end of the day, give me the big fat check. So at this moment, I think we've had a great discussion today. Thank you so much for watching Realty Plus on Republic Television. Thank you.